I'm going to discuss about two different tests, agglutination inhibition test and Combs test. Agglutination inhibition test is a different kind of test which is generally used for detection of pregnancy, rubella antigens or mumps virus antigen. Because some of the viruses inherently have the ability to cause coagulation of blood, just like the way the coronavirus has the ability to cause coagulation of blood when a person is infected by coronavirus. Since the antigens or the proteins of the virus has the ability to coagulate blood, in order to avoid false positive reaction, this test was developed. But later, it has been extended to different types of antigens. So I'm going to take the example of the agglutination inhibition test for the pregnancy. Here, the requirements are the human chorionic gonadotropin coated latex beads. HCG stands for human chorionic gonadotropin. It is a peptide hormone secreted by the chorion, which is the placenta, one of the components of the placenta. And this hormone is secreted in the pregnant women and it is excreted in the urine. It will make its presence in the urine when the woman is pregnant. So HCG can be extracted and purified from the pregnant urine, and that HCG can be used for developing the antibodies against it by injecting the pure HCG into any animal like rabbit, sheep, goat or horse. The antibody developed against the HCG is called anti-HCG. And the anti-HCG and the HCG are the two important materials that are required in the test kit. And the urine sample of the woman to be tested for pregnancy. Now, how this test is performed, let us see. Here, the latex beads, which are shown in yellow color, are coated with the HCG hormone using a hapten carrier. That may be a linker molecule. And the anti-HCG is nothing but a simple IgG antibody molecule, immunoglobulin G antibody molecule, which is produced in the animal after injecting the pure HCG into the animal. Let us say the urine sample has come to the lab for testing. To that urine sample, the anti-HCG is added and it is mixed well. And after that, this latex beads coated with HCG is added. Once again, mixed well. Then observe for visible clumping. The reaction is shown here. In this reaction, you can make out if the urine sample which has come for test does not contain the HCG, then the coated latex particle with HCG when added to it, and then when you add the anti-HCG to it, the coated latex particles get readily clumped by the anti-HCG, and that visible clumping can be seen like this. And the reaction will be in this manner. The urine sample negative for HCG will show the clumping of coated latex particles. The latex particles are coated with HCG. Therefore, there will be agglutination of latex particles, and visible agglutination is shown at the bottom on a red tile where the latex particles are showing agglutination. That urine sample is negative for pregnancy. Suppose the urine sample contains the HCG hormone in it. The HCG hormone readily reacts with the anti-HCG that is added to it, and almost all hormone will be bound by the antibody. And then to that, when you add the latex bead coated with HCG, it will remain free without agglutination because the antibody molecules are already engaged by the hormone that is present in the urine sample. So therefore, there will be no clumping of the latex beads, and the reaction is shown in a visible manner as shown in the slide here at the bottom on the red tile. You can see that the latex beads are free and they are not agglutinated. In the previous example, the latex beads are agglutinated. So agglutination of the latex beads indicates the urine sample is negative for HCG, whereas non-agglutination of the latex beads indicates the urine sample is positive for HCG. So since the reaction is a reverse type of reaction, where the hormone that is present, HCG, is readily agglutinated by the antibody, therefore latex beads will not be agglutinated by the antibody when they are added, therefore this reaction is called as agglutination inhibition reaction. In the sense, latex beads are not agglutinated because the antibody is already engaged in binding to the hormone that is readily present in the urine. So therefore, the reaction is called as agglutination inhibition reaction. Similarly, same tests, different types of tests can be done for viral antigens, where you have latex beads coated with different types of viral antigens, like, as I already mentioned, like rubella virus antigen or mumps antigen, or probably now the kits will be developed for coronavirus detection by binding the latex beads with coronavirus antigen. I will move to the another type of agglutination test, which is called as Coombs test, which is named after the scientist Coombs. He was the first person to develop anti-human serum, where he injected the normal healthy human serum into animals and developed anti-human serum. And he also showed that by injecting human immunoglobulins or human antibodies into animals, one can develop anti-human immunoglobulin. Anti-human globulin or immunoglobulin is nothing but antibody developed in an animal against a human antibody. A human antibody which is in the purified form injected into the animal will develop anti-human antibody. Here in this case, the Coombs test is done for the identification of Rh factor, where the Rh positive individual who has Rh antigen will react with Rh antibody. The Rh positive antigen is present on the RBCs. The Rh factor antigen is present on the membranes of the RBCs. And that Rh antigen induces the production of Rh antibody in Rh negative individual. Say for example, if the Rh positive child is developing in a Rh negative mother. In her womb, the Rh positive child will induce the mother to produce the antibody against the Rh antigen. And this Rh antibody, in fact, will cause a disease called as erythroblastosis fetalis in the developing fetus. In the sense, the RBCs of the fetus will undergo lysis because the mother's antibodies, that is Rh antibodies, can diffuse through the placenta and go through the umbilical cord and enter into the fetus and destroy the fetal RBC. And the baby will be born as blue baby due to deficiency of RBCs. So in order to avoid this complication, the Coombs test is performed. The reason being, the Rh antibodies are generally IgG antibodies. And IgG antibodies are poor agglutinators. They can't cause good amount of agglutination, unlike the blood group antibody. That is, A blood group or B blood group antibodies or IgM antibodies. And IgM antibodies are strong agglutinators. They cause very strong agglutination reaction and clumping of RBCs. Whereas Rh antibodies being IgG cause very weak agglutination. Sometimes it remains unidentified or it may give false positive reaction if it is not detected properly. To avoid this complication, the Coombs test is performed by using an anti-human IgG which is developed against the Rh antibody. And that anti-human IgG will react with the Rh antibody, which in fact binds to the Rh positive red blood corpuscles. Now let us take what is direct Coombs test. Direct Coombs test is nothing but as soon as the child is born to the Rh negative mother, after cutting the umbilical cord, the small amount of blood is collected, and to that blood, which contains the RBCs, the anti-human IgG, that is anti-Rh antibody, is added. When the anti-Rh antibody is added, if the child's blood RBC is Rh positive, and if it is already bound by the Rh antibodies of the mother, because they can easily diffuse through the placenta of the mother, they will have the antibodies bound to the RBC, that is mother's antibodies, which are shown in black here. To that, when you add anti-human IgG, that is anti-Rh antibody, that will easily recognize the antibodies of the mother bound to the RBC and cause clumping of the RBC. That indicates the child is Rh positive and child readily had the mother's antibody bound to the RBC, and child needs extra care because it has already suffered erythroblastosis fetalis reaction. In a simplified way, if the reaction has to be shown here the antibodies are bound to the RBC To that, you are adding the Coombs anti-IgG. And that anti-IgG is against the Rh antibody that recognizes that and binds to it and brings about clumping. And this is called as direct test. Why? Because you have taken the blood from the umbilical cord of the child and you have done the direct test, where the RBCs that are readily bound with the mother's Rh antibodies are recognized. Now, indirect test is a different type of test where you need the Rh positive blood corpuscles from any individual, any human being. You take the Rh positive RBC, wash them thoroughly in normal human saline. After washing them thoroughly in the normal human saline, suspend them in small quantity of normal human saline. To that, now you add the Rh negative mother's serum sample. When you add Rh negative mother's serum sample, if she readily contains very high titer Rh antibodies, those Rh antibodies will bind to the Rh positive RBC and they will be actually bound to the membrane of the RBC. To this sample now, in the second step, you add anti-human Rh antibody, that is anti-human IgG. When you add anti-human IgG to that, if mother readily had high titer of Rh antibody, which would have bound to the Rh positive RBCs, it will cause immediate clumping of those Rh positive RBCs. And that clumping will indicate that mother had high titer Rh antibodies. The Rh antibodies are shown in black, which are readily bound to the RBC. To that, you have added anti-human IgG, which is nothing but anti-Rh antibody, which is raised in the animal, and that will cross-link these Rh antibodies that are readily bound to the RBC, which were showing very weak agglutination. Now, binding, cross-linking of the Rh antibodies by the anti-human IgG will result in strong agglutination reaction. Since it is an indirect way of proving where the Rh positive RBCs used from other individual to which you have added the Rh negative mother's serum sample and demonstrating the agglutination of the RBC, it is called as indirect Coombs test. Once again, it can be shown in a simplified manner as shown in this slide, where the serum of the patient refers to Rh negative mother, added to the Rh positive RBCs, which gets readily bound by the mother's Rh antibodies, and to that you are adding anti-human IgG, which is nothing but anti-Rh antibody, which causes intense agglutination. So, the Coombs test is generally done to identify the Rh antigen, and it is very important, especially in the case of Rh negative mother carrying Rh positive child, because it causes complications to the child and results in the disease erythroblastosis fetalis. To avoid this disease complication, if one identifies the Rh antibodies in the mother, which are there in high titer, the mother can be given the antibody treatment against the Rh antibody to prevent the damage to the child from the third month of pregnancy itself, so that the child will develop without erythroblastosis fetalis, and the child will not suffer from the deficiency of RBCs. Thank you.